Good morning, my dear children. So in previous video we have discussed about presentation of the data and frequency of data. And in frequency of data we have discussed about ungrouped frequency distribution table, how to represent ungrouped frequency distribution table and grouped frequency distribution table. And also we have discussed about the class intervals, like exclusive class intervals, which are in a continuous form, like 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, these class intervals which are in a continuous form. So today let us discuss about inclusive class intervals. So children, to understand in what you mean by inclusive class intervals, let us consider one example. Consider the following frequency distribution table, which gives the weights of 38 students of the class. You observe the table here, children. Here weights in kgs, they have given 31 to 35, 36 to 40, 41 to 45, 46 to 50, 51 to 55, and so on, 71 to 75. Here you observe the table here, children. You observe the classes in this table. 31 to 35, 36 to 40, these classes are not in a continuous form. Okay, such type of class intervals, we call them as inclusive class intervals. And they have given number of students also, frequency, like 31 to 35, 9 students, 36 to 40, 5 students, 41 to 45, 14 students, and so on. 71 to 75, one student, total 38 students are there. So, suppose if two new students of weight 35.5 and kgs and 40.5 kgs are admitted in this class. Suppose two new students of weight 35.5 and 40.5 kgs are admitted in this class. Then in which interval we will include them, children? We cannot add in the first interval. We cannot include in the first interval. Because in first interval what you are having, 31 to 35. The new student is 35.5. We cannot include in first interval, or we cannot include in second interval also. Isn't it? And another boy of weight 40.5. And you cannot include in second interval or in a third interval, isn't it? Now, in such cases, let us construct real limits. Real limits or boundaries, we can also call it as a boundaries. Okay. So, to find out the boundaries, children, let us consider the first class interval, 31 to 35. And the second class interval, 36 to 40. Okay. Now you see here, the lower limit of 36 to 40. What is the lower limit there, children? 36, isn't it? And the upper limit of class intervals, 31 to 35. You have considered 31 to 35. What is the upper limit there? 35, isn't it? Now let us do difference of both. 36 minus 35. We got here 1. Half the difference means half of 1 by 2, which is equal to 0.5. Okay, now children, now what you have to do to write the new class intervals using the boundaries, how to write new class intervals? You take first class interval 31 to 35. In the first class interval, for a lower 31 to 35, what is the lower limit there? 31. So to 31, you have to subtract 0.5. And the upper limit is what there? 35, isn't it? So to 35, you should add 0.5. Then what you will get here, children? 31 minus 0.5 is 30.5. 35 plus 0.5 is 35.5. Now you got first class interval has 30.5 to 35.5. Similarly, next one you consider 36 to 40. Okay, lower limit is 36. to lower limit, you should subtract 0.5. Then you will get there 35.5. And the what is upper limit there? 40. To upper limit, you should add 0.5. Then you will get 40.5. So what are the second class intervals? 35.5 to 40.5. Next class intervals you see. Similarly, children, 41 to 45, lower limit is 41. So what you have to do to lower limit? Subtract 0.5. Then you will get the 40.5. Next, upper limit is what there? 45. To 45, you should add 0.5. Then you will get 45.5. Then you observe the class intervals here, children. Here you got here 40.5 to 45.5. You observe here 30.5 to 35.5, 35.5 to 40.5, 40.5 to 45.5. Here you have changed these class intervals to exclusive class intervals, which are in a continuous form. Now you observe the class intervals, children. Here 30.5 to 35.5, 35.5 to 40.5, 40.5 to 45.5, and so on, 70.5 to 75.5. Okay, now it is possible for us to include the weight of two new students. What is the weight of two new students here? 35.5 and another weight is 40.5, isn't it? Now, one more problem arises here, children. 35.5 appears in both the classes, first class intervals and second class interval also, isn't it? Then in which class do you think this weight should be considered? Isn't it? It is considered in both the classes, so it will be counted twice. You should include in only one class interval. Isn't it? So 35.5 we have to include in the second class interval only, because in first class interval what you will consider 30.5 to 34.5 only you will consider in the first class interval. In second class interval 35.5 to 39.5 you have to consider. So one new boy weight is how much here? 35.5. So here before it is 5 there, plus 1, so totally number of students is 6 here. Similarly, you will do for 40.5 also. 40.5 you should include in the class interval 35.5 to 40.5. Now this is, and here what you will have before, you have 14 number of students plus 1, you will get the 50 number of students. So this is how you will represent inclusive class intervals converting into boundaries, and you will represent in this form, in this form. So this is a new frequency distribution table. So today, children, let us discuss about few exercise sums from exercise 9.1. See, the first question in exercise 9.1, write the mark-wise frequency in the following frequency distribution table. They have given their marks up to 5 and number of students 5. Up to 6, 11. Up to 7, 19. Up to 8, 31. Up to 9, 40. Up to 10, 45. Now we have to represent this in a frequency distribution table. See the solution here. We have represented marks here, and marks you have written here up to 5, up to 6, up to 7, up to 8, up to 9, up to 10. Next, number of students, frequency 5, 11, 19, 31, 40, 45. So already they have given here frequency, so you let us represent this in a form of tally marks. Okay, children, 5 means 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5th one you will have a cross. I think so you know how to represent the tally marks. Next one is 11. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and one line. And next one is 19, Next one is 31, 40, 45. This is how you will represent a frequency distribution table. Now let us see fifth sum in exercise 9.1. Represent the data in the edges and bar graph as frequency distribution table. See children, they have given this bar graph here. By seeing this bar graph, you have to write a frequency distribution table. So see solution here, you have to represent a tabular form types of vehicles and frequency number of vehicles. Okay, types of vehicles, what are they? Cars, bike, auto and auto and cycle. Okay, so you see here cars children, on the graph you observe here cars means, you see it is 25 here, you have represented on the x-axis 25. So number of vehicles, cars, you will write there 25. Next bikes you have 45, you have 45 here. Next autos are how much there? 30, you have 30 there. So and last one is cycles, which represents 40. This is how you can represent frequency distribution table by seeing the graph. Okay. So children, from exercise 9.1, 1 to 6 sums are only there for in your syllabus children. 7, 8, 9 they have deleted from the syllabus. Okay. So this is all for today children. I hope so you have understood today's content. Please rewatch the video for better understanding and complete the assignment given today. Thank you and have a great day.